I do not know which is the truth, whether the last 2 years what we are already facing is the recession, or what people are saying the next 6 months is going to be worse, is that the real recession? But the fact is, there is an impact on sales across the board, across the country. And so what happens? If there is an impact on sales, it impacts all the real estate developers, the developer himself, the customers, the suppliers, and the employees. Of course, it end of the day, we keep hearing news of this brand has already relieved so many employees. The rest of the brands are already in, some have reduced considerable numbers, some are reducing small numbers, some have reduced the salaries and things like that. So it has an impact overall. It's not that we can wish away and say, okay, sales is slow, things will just get back to normal soon. So what is causing the changes? Obviously, we all know it's a no-brainer at this point of time. The GST, the RERA, the demonetization, they have all led to where we are at this point of time. And more so is also the consumer behavior, which is something that we cannot forget. While the rest of the things can be managed, the consumer behavior is something that you and I cannot really manage, because that's the way we are all going to be behaving as a consumer to any particular product. So we were living in a time when we used to do pre-launch in the air. So we were literally selling what was in the moon, right? So we did not have a Vikram lander, but we were still selling space on the moon. We were saying this is the land and this is likely to be the project. So you will likely to get 1,000 square feet, and you likely to start by this time and likely to end by this time. So we were all selling a dream or a piece of paper or a verbal commitment. So we have moved from there. We have now moved to a more recognized unit for sale. So what RERA has done is has identified the plot, has identified the approvals, has identified the unit number, has fixed the area of the apartment. So today when we do a pre-launch, the customer or the buyer or the investor exactly knows what is he buying. So there is a huge shift in the way things have started happening. People have now started buying more of ready than under construction, because of the faith is yet to come back in spite of RERA. Over and above this, there is a new segment which has already cropped up. The rental housing has already cropped in. The co-living has already started. The co-working has already started. And that's on the changing scenario as far as the markets are concerned. So even the developers will possibly have to rewrite their portfolios. Maybe the developers will not be able to just sustain 100% sale business. So everybody has to carve out certain amount of rental housing or co-working or whatever. Insolvency code, the banking regulation changes, has also brought in considerable amount of stress on all corporations right now. So that's on one side. So what is happening on the channel partner side, on the broking side? That's again another very interesting scenario. Earlier we used to have brokers, and I think that was the only word. So somebody invented channel partners because they wanted to identify themselves little better than a broker. So people said, I'm not a broker, I'm a channel partner. So we said, okay, fine, you're a channel partner. Now that has now transformed into a much more professional setup in terms of either a marketing agency or a channel partner, but recognized by RERA. So that's the shift which has happened. So today, if there is a crime in real estate, both will go down together, right? The broker also will go down along with the developer. So he will become a partner in crime. So he is equally now more careful before taking up a particular project or putting up a project in the market. And we had few IPCs, international property consultants like the JLL, the CBREs, the Knight Franks and the Colliers. That's about it. Then came the institutional property consultants. We had the bankers stepping in, like the ICICI Home Search, the HDFC Realty people. So they all started coming in. Then came the portal people, the quicker.coms, the housing.coms. So all of these people started coming into real estate broking. So if you see the way things have slowly panned out in the last 7, 8, 9 years, things have anyway started changing as far as real estate marketing is concerned. Now, in my personal observation is that we are no more going to be doing marketing, we are going to be distributing. We will soon be distributing real estate like how a mutual fund is distributed. So therefore, the shift towards channel partners or the marketing agencies or the IPCs is inevitable. We cannot wish that away. I think my statistic says 60-70% of the sales currently in the country is all through channel partners. So while these have come in, so now we have the large IPCs, institutional property consultants. So we have the Square Yards, the 360 Degrees, the Remax, and the Prop Tigers. So all these organizations have now come in where people have left their good jobs, either from Wall Street or from multinational banks or Indian large corporations. They have started these companies, which is now started going global. So we had those international companies working here. Now we have these Indian companies opening up branches in London, US, Singapore, and all these places. So I think there is a paradigm shift in the way the markets have started changing. That's on one side. So that's our scenario as to what has happened. There's another truth we have to, like the panel to keep in mind is, what is happening to the cost? So on one side, the marketing cost has gone up. With all these people coming in, they have started creating their own formula. Somebody says, I will walk on ladders. Somebody says, I will do the marketing, so you pay me more, so you don't do the marketing. Somebody says, you give me 10 to 12%, I will pay the other broker, I will do the marketing, I will do everything for you. You just only take the bookings from me and you service it. So another guy says, I will also service it for you till certain times. So the way things have now started changing, and with prop tech companies coming in, now they have started coming in with their own concepts of what value addition they can bring on the table for a developer, how to increase the sales, how to get the efficiency higher, and how to bring down the cost. But having said that, it is a dilemma for the developer, whether do I really now pay 10 to 12% for a marketing agency while my prices have gone down or it is not escalating and my margins have already gone down. So there is a huge dilemma as far as the developer is concerned as to how does a developer manage this particular aspect of low margins, low profit, no price hike, market has been flat for the last few years. Possibly it will stay flat for the next couple of years. And the technology playing another role. I think we were just getting used to using Yahoo and Google for marketing. So some people were just trying it. It took some 5-6 years before developers really thought, yes, I must start using this method or the medium. And suddenly came in the digital and the social media. And now I think in a year's time from now, I think artificial intelligence will play a much bigger role in marketing in real estate than what we are seeing today. So technology is again rapidly changing in the way things are happening. So developers are now left with many options. In one way I look at it, it is good for the developers because so they have their own sales and marketing team, a full-fledged sales and marketing team, which can do the marketing and sales. So they go to the brokers, they go to the customers directly, they do their own marketing, or they go to these IPCs and marketing agencies and get higher velocity and maybe get higher volumes and maybe pay later. I think that's one blessing for the developer is when you use these channels, you don't pay upfront because these channels do the marketing, they get paid only after the sale has happened. So all of this is happening on one side. The legal impact is also changing. I think I don't have to talk about legal issues when you're talking in the NCR region especially. We are all witness to what is happening on the legal front. So we have a legal expert here, so I will get him to have a word on that front. So the question is, do developers really have to keep the sales infra going, or can they outsource it to these CPs, and what is the kind of value addition? So I will allow the panelists to speak for a minute or two on their own, then we'll get into some amount of questioning to the panel, then I'll open it for the audience. Thank you.
Good evening, friends. A very happy Onam to you. I definitely believe that this is going to be a beautiful harvest for us. Starting with today, we enter the festive season. And I think there's a lot of buoyancy and there's a lot of excitement building up, both in the channel partner community as well as the developers. And there is a lot of hope. And all that hope comes from the fact that we have seen, at least my three decades roller coaster ride in real estate. The reality is that we've seen absolutely unbelievable highs, unbearable lows, and absolutely unfathomable resurgence. So our industry, the only constant is uncertainty in our industry. Now we are actually witnessing so much of it, but when I did my PhD, my topic was actually adaptability and intelligent growth in fluctuating cyclic markets. And at that time, everybody actually believed that real estate only goes one way upwards. But now, having seen the mountains, the valleys, the plateaus, the plains, and once again that same cycle, I think it's a very simple product that we all market. You know, I mean, you may call it commercial or residential, or you may, you know, whatever, retail, hospitality, whichever category. But the fact is, it's a very simple product. And if you understand what the customer wants, ya to aapka product ka pricing bilkul sahi ho, ya aapke product ki planning bilkul sahi ho, to koi chinta ka vishay nahi hota hai. Kyunki jo customer chah raha hai, wo agar aap de paaye, कॉम्प्लिकेशन वहाँ पे आता है जहाँ पे थोड़ा सा या तो मार्केट समझने में हम लोगों को प्रॉब्लम हो जाती है, बहुत बड़ी चीज़ बना देते हैं गलत लोकेशन पे जहाँ छोटी की ज़रूरत है, या फिर अपने आप ही हम लोग प्राइसेस एक ऐसे रेट पे ले जाते हैं इन्वेस्टर्स को अट्रैक्ट करने के लिए जहाँ पे सस्टेन नहीं कर पाता है, रियली द मार्केट इज़ नॉट देयर, यू नो. सो There has to be some kind of a balance between need and greed. And channel partners as well as developers both have to be very conscious of that fact, that what is it the market wants and how can we give them what they want. There has to be futuristic planning, but that futuristic planning should be related to infrastructure, it should be related to sustainability, it should be related to environment, you know, and all those investments need to be made there. So I am basically of this view, and of course I will end my talk on the note that I think we definitely need more women in real estate. You know, agar jada ladies hongi ghar bechne ke liye to definitely jada ghar
bechenge. So will that increase sales?
And main akeli reh jati hu har panel mein, and I just, you know, we just need a balance. Thank you.
So well, I hope that increases sales for the developers. Yeah. Okay, I'd like to hear from Mr. Pradeep Agarwal. He's a finance man as well as a developer now. So what is your take on going forward? How do we increase sales? What is the kind of channel do you think is best suited for us?
Good evening, everybody. First of all, do teen cheeze iske beech mein alag alag main aapko bataunga. Jaise abhi Augustine ne bhi apni discussion mein bataya, जो रियल इस्टेट है, मुझे ये लगता है कि आज एक ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन के दौर से गुजर रहा है, और ये बात हम सब लोगों को अंडरस्टैंड करनी, यानी जो कस्टमर है वो पैसा ऑनलाइन दे के खुश है. तो जो पहले वाला ट्रेडिशनल माइंडसेट था कि इतने परसेंट ब्रोकरेज होगी या ऐसा काम होगा, शायद थोड़ा अब वो चेंज हो गया है. तीसरी बड़ी बात, एनवायरनमेंट बिल्कुल बदला हुआ है, पहले जैसे प्रोडक्ट नहीं है, जो कंप्लायंस लेवल है वो बिल्कुल डिफरेंट लेवल पे चला गया है. रेरा जैसी अथॉरिटी के साथ पहले कभी किसी डेवलपर ने काम नहीं किया, अब वो अथॉरिटी आपके पास है. तो आप ये मान के चलिए, आज कस्टमर जो है वो किंग है. ऑलरेडी बहुत सारे राइट्स उसके पास हैं. तो जो भी प्रोडक्ट है हम जो दे रहे हैं, जो कमिट कर रहे हैं, प्रॉमिस कर रहे हैं, वो हमें उसे देना पड़ेगा, ये मान के चलें, तभी हम आगे जा सकते हैं. अदरवाइज़ आने वाले टाइम में, क्योंकि अगर पीछे एक डाटा देखें पिछले 6 महीने का, तो जो डेवलपर हैं जो दिल्ली में, दिल्ली NCR में लगभग 82 के नियर अबाउट डेवलपर्स थे जो एक्टिव थे. लास्ट 6 महीने में या 1 साल में आप कहें, वो डेवलपर केवल घट के 20 रह गए हैं, 20 जो एक्टिव हैं. तो आप समझ सकते हैं कि जो डेवलपर इस कंप्लायंस को मैनेज नहीं कर पा रहे हैं या समझ नहीं पा रहे हैं, बड़ा मुश्किल होगा. तो मुझे लगता है थोड़ा सा माइंडसेट चेंज ज़रूर करना है. अदरवाइज ये इंडस्ट्री बहुत बड़ी है. आज भी जो IRR रियल इस्टेट में है, मुझे नहीं लगता किसी और इंडस्ट्री में है. थैंक यू.
थैंक यू. मिस्टर प्रदीप जैन, व्हाट इज़ योर टेक ऑन दिस?
गुड इवनिंग फ्रेंड्स. माई माइंडसेट इज एंटायरली डिफरेंट. हमने बात की रिसेशन की. देखिए, पिछले 30 साल में 7 बार रिसेशन इस देश में आया. इस बार का जो रिसेशन है, पिछले 4 साल से रियल इस्टेट को का रिसेशन है. रियल इस्टेट का रिसेशन एंटर टू द अदर इंडस्ट्रीज लाइक ऑटो, फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज, टेक्सटाइल एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा. पिछले 2 साल में स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम द डिमोनेटाइजेशन, देन GST, देन रेरा एटसेट्रा, आज डेवलपर के लिए सबसे बड़ा जो चैलेंज है, नया माल बेचने का चैलेंज नहीं है. सबसे बड़ा चैलेंज है जो उसने माल बेचा हुआ है उसको किस तरीके से वो सस्टेन करे. 90% डेवलपर्स के प्रोजेक्ट डिले हैं, किसी के अपनी वजह से हैं, किसी के सरकार की वजह से हैं. अब अगर सरकार की वजह से हैं, सैंक्शंस की वजह से हैं, एनवायरनमेंट की वजह से, कल्प्रिट डेवलपर है. पिछले 4 से 5 साल में अगर देखें, किसी भी विसिनिटी में आप चले जाइए एंड अक्रॉस द कंट्री यू कैन टेक द डेटा, 99% प्रोजेक्ट्स के अंदर प्रीमियम नहीं है. 99% प्रोजेक्ट में अगर प्रीमियम नहीं है, हर प्रोजेक्ट के अंदर जब हम ड्राइंग रोड के ऊपर प्रॉपर्टी बेचते हैं कस्टमर को, तो वो ये सोच के खरीदता है कि मैं आज बुकिंग करूँगा, डेवलपर के ऑफिस से निकलूँगा. जो 2007, 2008, 2009 का माइंडसेट है कि डेवलपर के ऑफिस में गया, 2 लाख रुपए का चेक उसको बुकिंग का दिया, सामने संजय नागपाल जी के ऑफिस में गया और 2.5 लाख रुपए या 3 लाख रुपए में वहाँ पे बिक गया, 1 लाख रुपए बन गए, वो जमाना चला गया. अब जमाना क्या है, वो कहता है भाई साहब मैंने 4,000 रुपये फुट में फ्लैट खरीदा था, डेवलपर ने प्रोजेक्ट भी कम्प्लीट कर दिया, अब डेवलपर ने फैसिलिटीज़ भी सारी दे दी, स्पेसिफिकेशन भी परफेक्ट है, लेकिन अब उसकी मेंटेनेंस ठीक नहीं है, इसलिए मुझे तो मेरा पैसा वापस दे दो. पैसा वापस चाहिए 24% इंटरेस्ट के लिए चाहिए. अच्छा, आप नहीं दोगे, कोई बात नहीं, मैं कंज्यूमर कोर्ट चला जाऊंगा, मैं NCLTC चला जाऊंगा. अभी एक नया फार्मूला मिल गया. मैं जब इस हॉल में घुसा तो साहब पूछ रहे थे NCLT, एक NCLT एक नया फार्मूला मिल गया, गैंगिंग शुरू हो गई है. देर आर द गैंग्स इन द मार्केट हु इज़ बाइंग द अपार्टमेंट विद एवरी डेवलपर एंड गोइंग इन टू द NCLT. तो ऐसे इन्वायरमेंट में मेरा तो अपना पर्सनल व्यू ये है कि रियल इस्टेट डेवलपर जो आज काम कर रहा है, उसको जो हाथ में काम है उसको सस्टेन करे, उसको कंसोलिडेट करे, उसको डिलीवर करे और कसम खा ले कि रेडी टू मूव इन फ्लैट बेचूंगा. क्या जरूरत है 50 प्रोजेक्ट बनाने की? किसकी सेवा कर रहे हो आप? किसकी सेवा कर रहे हो? सरकार की, जो आपकी ऑनलाइन कहती है मैं 90 डेज में सेंक्शन दूंगा और 390 डेज में मिलती नहीं है. अफसर कहता है ऑफलाइन दिखा दो, फीस तय कर लो, ऑनलाइन डाल दो. तो किसकी सेवा करना चाहते हो? रेडी बेचो ना रेरा ना अपना NCLT ना कुछ, पैसे दे जा. और आज पता क्या स्थिति हो गई, जैसे सबने देखा होगा ट्रक चलता है रोड के ऊपर, ड्राइवर गाड़ी चला रहा है, पीछे लिखा होता है, क्या लिखा होता है उस पर? नहीं, उस पर लिखा होता है नजर हटी दुर्घटना घटी. तो रियल इस्टेट डेवलपर की आज वो स्थिति है. जो इन्वायरमेंट आज चल रहा है, अगर यही इन्वायरमेंट चलता रहा तो मैं अभी मीटिंग रूम में बात कर रहा था कि 180 दिन में हिंदुस्तान की 90% कंपनी NCLT हो जाएंगी. कोई रोक नहीं सकता उसको, क्यों नहीं रोक सकता? एक प्रोजेक्ट, अभी मैं डेवलपर का नाम नहीं लूंगा, इज नॉट राइट वे, एक प्रोजेक्ट जो कि 100% कंप्लीट है, ओसी उसका आया हुआ है, वन ऑफ द लीडिंग डेवलपर ऑफ दिस कंट्री उसका पार्टनर है, कस्टमर को समझ नहीं आया, क्यों? 4000 में फ्लैट खरीदा था, 8000 में बिकता नहीं है, इंटरेस्ट के साथ उसको 9000 रुपये मिलते हैं, वो एनसीएलटी गया, कंपनी आईआरपी अपॉइंट हो गया, अब क्या होगा? आप नए प्रोजेक्ट की बात कर रहे हो, प्रदीप जी ने बताया कि भी बहुत अच्छी सेल हो रही है, गुड लक। अब होगा क्या कि एक लैंड आपने परचेज की, पूरा उसका सेंक्शन करा लिया, 100% कंप्लायंस विद इन टाइम फ्रेम, विद इन द स्पेसिफिकेशन, सब चीज़ परफेक्ट है, लैंडर से पैसा मिल गया आपको लोन का, रेरा का भी रजिस्ट्रेशन हो गया, सारी चीज़ें इस पर कंप्लायंस चल रही है। लेकिन होगा क्या कि एक कस्टमर आपके पास आया, उसने कहा भाई साहब मुझे तो 24% ब्याज के साथ पैसे वापस कर दो। अब प्रदीप जी कहेंगे यार मेरी तो ये 15 चीज़ें मैंने कही थी, 15 तो हैं, मैं 16वीं भी साथ में दे रहा हूँ, तो मैं वापस क्यों दूंगा? वो कहेगा भाई साहब आप नहीं दे रहे हो ना तो मैं तो चला एनसीएलटी। अब जब वो एनसीएलटी जाएगा तो जो 1000 अपार्टमेंट मैंने बेचे हैं, व्हाट गोइंग टू बी हैपन विद 999 अपार्टमेंट? देर आर द केसेज इन द मार्केट जहाँ पर मान लो 500 अपार्टमेंट हैं, 470 उसके आरडब्ल्यूए के मेंबर हैं, आरडब्ल्यूए के साथ डेवलपर ने एग्रीमेंट किया हुआ है, 100% एज पर द एग्रीमेंट ऑन ट्रैक है। अब वो 30 कस्टमर में से 3 कस्टमर कहते हैं यार हमें नहीं पता, आरडब्ल्यूए को पैसे खिला के डेवलपर ने एग्रीमेंट साइन कर लिया, एनसीआरडीसी के भी ऑर्डर हैं, हाई कोर्ट के भी ऑर्डर हैं, सब चीज़ सेटल्ड है, वो कहता हमें नहीं पता, हमें तो 24% ब्याज के साथ पैसा देता है, तो ठीक है, नहीं तो चलो भैया एनसीएलटी। थैंक यू वेरी मच।
सो आई थिंक दैट्स अ वेरी या वी विल कम बैक टू यू ऑन क्यू एंड ए सेशन, आई विल कम बैक टू यू, लेट मी लिसन फ्रॉम द चैनल पार्टनर साइड व्हाट इज देयर व्यूज, देन आई विल गो टू द लीगल साइड।
दैट वाज क्वाइट एनकरेजिंग, राइट? Now, we started our business in India in 2009, and I think we always say this, that I think we are the children of recession. We haven't seen, I think, the best period in real estate, as people say, which is the 2000s, wherein people felt that project launch hota tha, aur checks aa jate the, aur ek din mein bik jata tha. Unfortunately, or I would say fortunately, we haven't seen that period. Since we haven't seen that period, we learned it the hard way. The initial years when we were setting the business was a little tough. And I think that hard way that we learned, that's the only reason, thankfully today, between all the things that we have been talking about in terms of a lull period of real estate, thankfully we have been going pretty strong. This is a conclave and conference for the northern market. Yes, it is a little bit of a challenge here, like for everybody, for us as well. But since we have offices all across the country, we don't see the problem in the same format or in the same situation when we go towards down south, when we go towards the western sides of the country. Especially, I think, when we talk about the southern market of India, wherein we have some of the most reputed real estate players, we haven't seen developers gone completely out of business over there. I know that there would be some of the other cases over there, but this problem has been more prominent in the northern real estate market now. And the recession that we all talk about, especially real estate, we see it more prominent here. And I think one of the biggest reason is, as Dr. Ananta rightly said, probably we took it to an unexpected, unreasonable kind of a hype. If we understand real estate from a complete layman's perspective, and not we don't try and get into too much of economics and too many details, for a layman's perspective, this is roti, kapda or makan, and makan is still a basic need. If we start trading with the basic need, this is exactly that would happen. And that's exactly what we started doing in the last 20 odd years, 2 odd decades, leaving the last 5 years. We traded with this commodity. We played with this commodity. We sold it to investors, and the investors wanted to make returns out of it. And at the end of the day, the end user was the one who was suffering the most with regards to unreasonable increase in prices. The developers got more and more ambitious because the sales were happening, and one project led to another, to another, to another. And when finally the market had a little bit of recession, that's when I think all the tables turned. And that's when we have started seeing exit of so many real estate developers from the market, because you can't be too ambitious with this industry. It's a high stake industry. And as I think Mr. Jain rightly said, yes, I think the idea is build one product, deliver one product, and then move on. I mean, at the end of the day, you're into a business decision, and you're into a business to make money and not into any kind of service. And I think no developer is, and it was not even their intention to be giving service to the probably society. The idea was to make money, and the right way to make money is build one, deliver one, move on to the next one. We at no point in time and at no way we can justify delays. I know that the government has a very, very, very strong role to play here, and probably I think whenever we have such discussions, I don't think only channel partners and developers need to be here. We need to have some representation maybe from the government as well, so that at least we have somebody to blame, right? We have somebody to pass the blame as well. So we need to have somebody who can answer from that behalf as well, because at the end of the day, most of the things that we've been talking about as reasons for this slowdown in real estate is because probably the government has brought in so many new different policies, as you said, from GST to demonetization to so many other things. But probably the way I look at, if the maybe implementation might be an issue, at least on the face of it, they look like that we are going in the right direction, we are headed towards the right direction. And yes, if someday the implementation goes right, the end user definitely would get the benefit out of it. Today, across the country, product which is rightly priced, product which is rightly located, product which has the right configuration. I mean, I don't think there has been any challenge in this market.
Then channel partners will not have much role to play.
Channel partners, as I think Mr. Agarwal said, that probably online is taking probably 1/4, 25% of the bookings as far as Signature Global is concerned. I think my only take is US is a market which is 30 years ahead of us, probably even 40 years ahead of us, in a market as organized, as transparent as United States. We still have, as a brand, as a company, 56,000 brokers going strong and steady. Online sales, they've not started there. I don't think in India ever, ever online sales, sales of real estate would ever be able to happen.
Kshitij, what is your take?
Hello, everybody.
In 2 minutes.
Yeah. I'm the least counted. So, starting from, like you said, the consumer, we had a larger platform of buyers earlier. It has changed completely. It is now being called as consumer. We had investors, like Pradeep here was saying, or Ananta ma'am was saying, that we used to, in a day, we used to sell a product of 1,000 crores and hundreds of apartments, or maybe 500 apartments in a day. There were times we were underwriters and we were brokers. And we, first of all, I would give it to brokers, because the hardest part is to sell and still make the least amount of money and still sustain that sale for 3 years or 4 years. There's a lot of running around that a broker does. So, like we were discussing about the direct team also. Direct team can only complement those sales with the broker. The broker can go extensively to any level, whether it be the climate conditions or whether it be the market conditions. I don't think something what a broker can deliver, anybody else can. The other thing that Saahil was pointing out, America, they've had recessions of 10 years. The most developed countries have had recessions of 10 years, 12 years. We've had the highest peak that we achieved, or the consistent market that we had, we've only had it for 5 years, at best. After that, because of the government things, because of the intervention of departments, we go burst. Oversupply is another reason. Randomly opening zones. Everywhere that you see, there are new zones opening, there is new supply line, which is not sustainable to sell. They can't sustain those number of houses. It's not happening at the primest of areas. They're happening all over. So the investors have vanished, they've lost all the money. The users, I don't see as many users will come back. The users, it's a wealthy, it used to be a wealthy country. I can't call it as wealthy a country anymore. But there used to be second houses, third houses people used to buy. Today, they're not even able to afford the first house. How they make it, how they do their reverse calculations, loans have become so difficult. I would say RERA has supported mostly the customer. What support is broker getting out of it? I'm registered, I've paid the fees. What is the support that I get? I don't get any support from them. There has to be some educative means. There has to be a training thing done so that everybody is at par and they become something which is an educated class. We still contribute so much to the industry, to the GDP, but we still don't get that kind of recognition.
All right. Okay, I'll come back on all of these and let me hear it from Sudhir Mishra. So what's happening on the legal side as far as real estate is concerned? Across. I'm not just talking about RERA.
Yeah.
Across.
So, Augustine, thank you for this opportunity. I'm literally the elephant in the room here now. Because one, I look like one, and secondly, I will say that as a lawyer sitting for actually talking about how to increase the sales, I have a very important insight for you. The insight is that we as lawyers, we work on flavors, we work on stories, we work on perception. Today the perception is that the top builders of this country are before Supreme Court on a weekly basis. And these are some of the topmost. We know I'm not taking names as well. I would request that most of the people who really want to know how the sentiments have died need to visit the Supreme Court, take a visitor's pass, I can arrange that. Go inside, sit in these judgments and see how this perception has been created that the builder is somebody who should be blamed for everything. Now, this is what is being reported in the newspapers. This is what is done on the prime time shouting new channels, where the same happened to doctors few years back. They now came back. They are now saying that if you hit a doctor, you'll be penalized for 7 years. So I'm telling you the perception. The courtroom has become the new war room for you. You're losing the perception battle, primarily the perception battle, which is so poorly managed today. I represented CREDAI Karnataka in National Green Tribunal and then finally Supreme Court on the whole lake issue. We got them the relief. And this was becoming a story and I put it properly. And naturally, this was very poorly being represented in the local newspapers in Bangalore and here. So my suggestion is that please, like very rightly said, that the RERA's perception is it is consumer friendly. National Commission, Competition Commission, criminal courts, economic offenses, all kind of, even Gangster Act now in UP. How do you expect as an industry body, how many sessions we are doing on these things, that who is going to write about these things? And I have never seen even in a panel this being discussed, and I'm volunteering to tell you, RERA is not a problem. Supreme Court is not a problem. Perception is the problem. If you will say that everybody is creating a feeling where you can't be trusted upon for no reason. And very rightly said by Jain Saab that, you know, there is a customer. Customer is portraying very clearly that it is my fundamental right to live in a house. But somebody who is already staying in a palatial house, he is an investor, serial investor. He has no right to kill the investments of bank. He has no right to kill the investment and the equity which you have already created. And I have been fighting the battles now. And as a policy, we have not taken any consumer group, any buyer group in the court, because that's the way I practice my law. And I'm telling you, when I go to court and when I see this one-sided debate, I see first hire a great PR agency at a CREDAI level, create a pool of writers who write for newspapers, the way Pepsi does, the way all these Coca-Cola pharma companies do. Start getting your stories. If you have done a good project, please start writing about it. If you said that you are able to sell good houses and you are getting 4% premium, why this is not coming in media?
But good stories don't sell.
No, they sell. iPhone is a story, because people buy iPhone because it's a story, it's an experience. Thank you.
All right. So I think that's another absolutely different view of what is happening on the legal side. Coming back to Mr. Pradeep Agarwal, you say the sales is doing good as far as your segment is concerned. So how much of it is through the channel partners, and would you recommend using channel partner marketing agency as one of your way to do business going forward?
नहीं, नेचुरली चैनल पार्टनर्स हम लोग भी हमारे पास लगभग 500 से ज़्यादा चैनल पार्टनर ऑलरेडी ऑल इंडिया बेसिस के ऊपर हैं हमारे पास, और 3500 के नियर अबाउट BDA हैं जो सब चैनल पार्टनर्स हैं. अभी जो डिस्कशन है वो इस चीज़ में कि बिजनेस जो है इवन द ब्रोकरेज साइड में वो भी चेंज हो रहा है. इवन सेम काम फाइनेंशियल मार्केट में हुआ है, बिल्कुल डिट्टो. 1995 की अगर हम बात करें, जो ब्रोकरेज रेट थे वो लगभग 3% 2% ऐसे ब्रोकरेज रेट चलते थे. अगर कोई रियल उस टाइम पे फाइनेंशियल मार्केट में कोई एक्टिव होगा, प्रदीप जी तो सबको जानते हैं, बिल्कुल चेंज हुआ. आज 2019 में जो ब्रोकरेज रेट हैं वो लेस देन 1000 रुपीज़ हैं, यू कैन से 500 ओनली. इवन दो डिस्काउंट ब्रोकरेज अवेलेबल है, जैसे रिचार्ज होता है, आप जाएं 5000 रुपये की ब्रोकरेज खरीद लाएं ब्रोकर से, जो काम आप करना चाहते हैं वो कर लें, उनका यही नहीं पता वो 300 रुपये करोड़ में काम कर रहे हैं 400 रुपये करोड़ में. यानी आप समझिए, जिस चीज़ पे 1 करोड़ रुपये पे 300,000 रुपये ब्रोकरेज होती थी, वो घटते घटते 500 रुपये रह गई, तो कितना चेंज आ गया. लेकिन वॉल्यूम जो हैं वो इतने ज़्यादा हो गए हैं कि 1995 में जो 100-200 करोड़ के वॉल्यूम होते थे, नाउ वो 20,00,000 करोड़ रुपए पर डे हैं, और जो ब्रोकरेज हाउसेज हैं उनके जो वैल्यूशन हैं वो 10,000 करोड़ से 15,000 करोड़ रुपए के बीच में हैं. तो मुझे लगता है कि जो टाइम है वो बिल्कुल चेंज है. इवन दो चैनल, जैसे अभी बताया मेरे कुलीग ने कि ये रियल इस्टेट अभी शायद ऑनलाइन बिकने में इंडिया जैसे जगह में थोड़ा सा टाइम लगेगा, बिल्कुल, लेकिन उसके बाद भी जो ब्रोकरेज रेट हैं वो कहीं ना कहीं ड्रॉप डाउन होंगे. जैसे अभी भी जो चैनल पार्टनर स्टार्टिंग में जब हम लोगों ने अफोर्डेबल में काम शुरू किया, तो हम लोग जब उनसे कहते थे कि एक फॉर्म जिसको आप फिल कराएंगे तो उस पर हम केवल 5,000 से 10,000 रुपये ब्रोकरेज देने वाले हैं, इसका मतलब 25,00,000 रुपये के फ्लैट पे 0.5% से कम पे ब्रोकरेज, वो कह रहे हैं सर हमने 5 से 10 मिनट में काम किया है, आप 0.5% की बात कर रहे हैं. कस्टमर ने डायरेक्ट आना शुरू कर दिया. अब धीरे धीरे ये सिचुएशन है कि उनको वो जो 5 से 10,000 मिलते हैं उस पर वो सर्वाइव कर रहे हैं, लेकिन जो वॉल्यूम है वो इतना ज़्यादा है कि उनको हर महीने 2,000-3,000 फॉर्म मिल रहे हैं, जो अगर वॉल्यूम वाइज जाए तो इन करोड़ सौ वो उसमें पैसा बना रहे हैं. तो वॉल्यूम जो वो बिल्कुल एंटायर चेंज हो गया है, आई थिंक सो. तो सेम चीज.
अनंत, व्हाट इज़ योर स्पेसिफिक टू यूजिंग चैनल पार्टनर और मार्केटिंग एजेंसीज टू take your products?
Augustine, definitely the developers and builders need to have very, very strong direct sales teams, as well as very strong marketing firms. Both these are absolutely essential. And if these two are right, and by right I mean, you know, as far as direct channels are concerned, the teams have to be very well trained. They must have answers to all the questions. And I think back when I started working, and that was in June 91, I think a lot of time used to be spent in training. It was actually serious business. You went department to department, sat at sites. You was expected to know the sewage line running through a township. I mean, it was quite crazy. But somewhere, you know, the good things that happened in the past somewhere got eroded now. So you straight away go to business school, you get the kids, and you expect them to start selling from day one. So investment on training is very important. And then the second thing comes is the leadership. Unity of command is required. The way sales is being handled in another industry, any other industry, whether it is FMCG or whether it is any industry, you name it, the type of aggression and the type of customer responsiveness that is there, and responsibility towards the customer, that also, I think, a lot of work is required in our industry. Yes, some of our industry colleagues here are spending a lot of time and energy in investing in that, bringing international standards, whether it's RICS and various others, but still a long way to go. So direct sales teams definitely are needed. If the direct engines and marketing firms, market research, you will get all your answers from your existing customers. If your CRM is strong, what didn't they like? What went wrong? Why aren't the payments coming? You can fix everything. Use the feedback as feed forward. That connection is also lacking. Everybody sits in silos and they do not use that information. between developers, the information is not shared. There are townships where 21 builders are on one highway, one next to the other. Even there, people are not getting their act right because we are not a very cohesive industry.
Sure.
And that is what I think my compliments to Tripti and Anuragji for putting all of us together, you know, and exchanging views. So direct marketing firms and channel partners will ride the wave. They are experts at pulling the check out of a customer's pocket. They will get it for you. But first have your own house in order. Thank you.
Pradeepji, what is your... How do you operate? What is your comfort level using channel partner and marketing companies?
See, in my view, without the channel partner to work as a real estate developer, I think is next to impossible. Okay. Pradeep ji case is little different because he's selling the affordable housing, A, B. Being into the capital market historically, he has a different kind of the network. Like, bataya 3500 ke kareeb inke sub channel partners hai. To ultimately, wo jo 3500 ke kareeb channel partner hai, wo real estate partner nahi hai. Wo inke financial market ke partner hai, jo inke liye us time pe financial paper ka kaam karte
the. Distribution
ho gaya. Aaj bhi ye wohi paper bech rahe hain jo 3500 apna 10 saal pehle bech rahe the. Wo financial market ka tha. अब रियल एस्टेट का है
सही.
तो इनका काम बेसिकली एक डिफरेंट है कि 1000 अपार्टमेंट है फार्म सेल करने के पैसे हैं लेकिन अगर रियल एस्टेट बेचना है रियल एस्टेट 25 लाख रुपए का फ्लैट रियल एस्टेट नहीं है इन माय व्यू इफ यू आस्क मी इन माय कंपनी आई थिंक द मिनिमम प्राइस मे बी 40-50 लाख टू 20 करोड़ रुपीस अब 20 करोड़ रुपए का फ्लैट जिस यू नो ऑफिसर को मैं 50,000 रुपए अपने यहां देता हूं वो 20 करोड़ रुपए का फ्लैट बेच के नहीं लाके दे सकता यू नो बिना चैनल पार्टनर के बिना पंडित जी के शादी हो ही नहीं सकती बड़ी सिंपल सी बात है तो अगर आप कहो साहब मैं कोर्ट में जाके शादी कर लूंगा तो भाई साहब वहां पे कोर्ट में भी अब सरकार पंडित उपलब्ध कराती है तब शादी होती है तो चैनल पार्टनर के बिना रियल एस्टेट बिजनेस हो ही नहीं सकता
थैंक यू सो व्हाट इज रीमैक्स What is your experience with developers in, do you all underwrite or you do regular sourcing for developers? How do you all, but very quickly in 45 seconds.
Sure. Thanks for making that clear. So when we talk about our side of the business, we never got into the underwriting stuff because I think as I rightly said, we started a very, very different time zone. I think the relationship between the developer and channel partner over the years has come to one of the best possible levels as far as we are concerned. Today, the engagement level between a channel partner and between the developer is at the best possible level. We have now started getting engaged with the developer at the time of even them working jointly in terms of organizing events with us, helping us in closures, sitting in our offices, helping us drive their marketing efforts. So we have become more like their extended marketing arm than just getting a check to them of the client.
Or a walk.
Some of the developers do even engage with certain reputed channel partners to even decide the configuration of the product, what pricing should they come out. So there is a lot of discussion even pre-launch rather than just using that channel partner
so more
to go fetch
from
a check
your
for him.
Side to the developer. Yes. Kshitij, what is your...
Just adding on to what Saahil said, you know, in my early years of career, when I was getting trained by Ananta ma'am or Pradeep bhaiya, so we used to definitely do that. We've always been part of the conceiving. You know, the layout used to be discussed, the way that we used to sell used to be discussed, and underwriting used to happen only post that. So the broker role hasn't changed. Maybe I see there is more technology being used now. The ways of selling is not primitive. What
so you now engaged even in the customer service part as well, or is it only up to the
You'll be
booking?
Surprised people who have been consistent in their business, they make sure that all the collections happen on time. They even make sure all the installments reach them on time. The transaction only closes when the possession happens. So there's a lot of work. We have our own CRM teams. There are constant people who are following it up.
So can the developer reduce their number of staff as far as sales and marketing is concerned?
The first thing I said is the developer staff the back office cannot be done away with.
Okay.
But the sales staff has to work hand in hand with the broker or the realtor, because that's only.
So, on the RERA side, with these brokers getting registered, as well as now on the legal side. So, are there any issues on? Do you see the on the legal side?
So, on a serious note, before RERA came also, it was because of the buyers taking channel partners in courts in variety of cases where they had a deeper hand holding or the product was very costly in 2009, 10, 11, 12. So they were so.
So this is very specific to the NCR region, I guess.
NCR region, where
may not
it
be rest
became
of
very
the country.
Systematic. It got reflected in the act because there were so many cases which were happening where channel partners were party, because they thought that these are the people we are interfacing and the pricing was fixed according to that. So the legally they got entangled. So I would say they have to be on the same page, especially on the pricing part. Where courts have come out very heavily that why a particular product through a channel partner has come for a particular price, why a particular product on a direct selling has come for a particular price. Even that has come under Competition Commission review and otherwise. So that would be a very important area for
you. So I think those days are now gone. Yes, I think now prices have almost become same. Yeah. Whether you sell internationally or in India or through channel partner or through direct. So with that, I will open it for about three questions to the audience. If there is any questions, yeah, please.
Hello. Yeah, I'm Ravinder Agarwal from Association of Certified Realtors of India. I would like to talk about, you know, what Jain Saab said about NCLT. Sir, NCLT ko government leke aayi hai and you are challenging the wisdom of Supreme Court of India. More than 150 builders had gone to Supreme Court. They had taken a stay and Supreme Court has vacated that stay. So you are challenging the wisdom of Supreme Court judges. I mean, hum apne aap ko zyada smart samajh rahe hain kya sab log?
I'm not challenging that. If you see the Supreme Court judgment within the line, are the NCLT talking about the same line? In what the Supreme Court judgment talks about? The Supreme Court judgment talks about the first consumer need to prove he is a home buyer, he is not an investor. The developer need to prove that. And the NCLT, the people who are going into the court, is not in the same line. You can see what going to be review in few days. And at the same time, you see, you are talking about the Supreme Court. I'm talking Parliament of India. Okay? The then officiating finance minister of this country made a statement into the Parliament how this IBC Act for consumer to be treated. If you want, if the organizers, they have the time, I can play before you.
Sir, what
you can read that.
Is that all the 100% people who are going to NCLT are all investors? There are no home buyers there?
No, I'm not saying that. But large number of the people is that.
Any other question? Anybody else? All right. I think with that we will end the session. So I think it was a very good, something different. I think now the developer community and the broking community both have started thinking alike. I think that's a big step as far as the industry is concerned. So that can only be a win-win for the industry going forward. So all the best and thank you very much for all the panelists. Thank you.
Well, thank you all so much. Those were some very strong perspectives.
Check, 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 check.
I would now once again like to invite Mr. Prateek Mathur, President, Business Development, Prism RMC, to present a token of appreciation to our esteemed panelists. Thank you all so much once again. I request everyone, please be seated, because it's now time for a check. May I request everyone to please be seated? Please take your seats. All right, and now, ladies and gentlemen, as we promised, here we have the man of the hour, architect Manit Rastogi, founding partner, Morphogenesis. Manit, an architect who consistently pushes the boundaries of sustainable design. His firm, Morphogenesis, has won over 95 international and national awards, which include being India's first World Architecture Festival Award winner. Rastogi graduated with distinction from the Sustainable Environmental Design Program under Simos Yanas and completed AA diploma with honors under John Fraser from Architectural Association. He's a founder member of the Griha Council and lectures extensively globally. He has co-authored Morphogenesis, first monograph, Morphogenesis, the Indian Perspective, the Global Context, published by Images Australia under their Master Architect series. But before I invite him up on stage, may I request everyone to please settle down, take your seats. We'll have plenty of time to take pictures. Gentlemen, please settle down. Please take your seats once again. I request everyone to please be seated. Once again, may I request everyone to please take your seats. Please make yourself comfortable. The gentleman towards the back, the ladies towards the back, I request you to please take your seats, please settle down. It's now time for a very interactive session, something that we've all been waiting for and looking forward to. I request you all to please take your seats, please maintain silence, and please put your mobile phones on silent mode. All right, we'll give everyone just 1 minute to settle down and take their seats. I want nobody should be missing out on this particular session. All right, it's now time to take this evening forward, and without any further ado, I would now like to invite on stage the man of the hour, architect Manit Rastogi, founding partner, Morphogenesis. Gentlemen, can we please welcome him on the stage with a big round of applause? Welcome.
Good evening, everyone. So I think the connections are, yeah. So I believe we're running a bit late, so I will try and keep this as short as I can. I heard the last couple of panels, and this seems to be the conversation everywhere in India. I mean, this whole notion of real estate and the notion of the fact that developers believe that the legal system is against them, the government is against them. The people believe that the developers are crooks. The brokers believe the developers, you know, so the whole ecosystem is one that is turned one of complaint. The financiers don't want to finance, you know, so. But the real issue, I think the real issue at hand is going back to that point of roti, kapda or makan. And I think that we, somewhere along the line, and in my last 2.5 decades of practice across India, is that this makan has turned into a commodity. It is sold as a ticket size, it's sold as an area, but it's not really thought of as part of a much larger ecosystem of a community. And I think that's where there's been a dramatic shift away from how we used to build and how we build today. And it is this commoditization that has pushed real estate to its brink where we are standing today. Now, I don't want to be critical of anything at all, but what I do want to point out is when we talk about brand India, what really comes to your mind? Okay, we're saying design. You know, okay, we can say Japanese design, or we say Spanish design, or we say German design. What comes to your mind when you say Indian design? What's the genre that comes to your mind? For in most places, and with most people, it's always our historical architecture, it's our heritage. No one talks about contemporary Indian architecture as a model for the rest of the world. Yes, people want to go to Barcelona, it's a great walking city, people want to go to Singapore, people, you know, and the government all the time is talking about how do we convert Bombay into Shanghai, Delhi into this, but what is our seed, what is our genre, what is our brand? If we don't begin to understand what